Hey guys, it's Gaba VR, and in this video I'll show you a new solution for creative 360 or Little Planet photography with a brand new camera. Let's make a clone effect in camera without further editing, even without having to use a special app. So let's jump into it. Maybe you are familiar with the clone or shadow clone effect, and there are already some editing tricks which can help you to achieve it. If you are interested about how you can do this even in video, check out my tips and tricks in this topic. But summarizing it, you need to take multiple 360 shots and then put them together even manually, or you can use some apps which create it for you using AI. But what if I say you can capture these cool shots even in camera without having to take multiple 360 photos or edit anything in post? Let me show you a new 360 camera, Trisio Lite 2, which is capable to do this. Originally it's an 8K virtual tour camera dedicated to create high resolution virtual tour photos, but as I got my hands on it, creating this trick was so obvious for me that I couldn't miss it. Anyway, in the next video I will show you how I use it for real estate photography, comparing the shooting and editing workflow with other 360 cameras and even with DSLRs. But now let me start with the creative usage of the camera. As I mentioned, Trisio Lite 2 is an 8K 360 camera with a little twist, as actually it's a one lens camera which turns around by itself on its own motorized mount, taking 4 photos to cover the entire 360 space. So the basic idea is to mix the traditional DSLR panoramic photo technique with point-and-shoot 360 cameras. And now I will take the advantage of that. Or actually, my basic idea is using the biggest downside of the old pano head technique and turning it into something cool. As you may know, panoramic photography is a serious problem with shooting moving objects, and it usually leads to some ghosting issues or funny results. But now I will intentionally hack the system and create a clone effect. First I put the camera on a tripod and a selfie stick. It can be only a mini tripod if you wish so, but now I shoot in a little bit higher angle. As always, the selfie stick will be invisible if it's in line with the body of the camera. Then I set up the position. My experience is that the starting position will be around 90 degrees from the position how you turn on the camera. During the short calibration process, it will turn around in the opposite direction, but finally end up around that 90 degrees position and start shooting while rotating backwards. The starting position of shooting is very important now, because I want to be on the picture, so I have to know my starting position too. Then I set up a self-timer and start shooting using the Trisio app. Or I can start shooting in standalone mode by pressing the shutter button on the side of the camera. I stay still until the first shot is taken and always move with the camera to the next position. Consider that this camera was designed for virtual tour photography, so usually it shoots with quite long exposures. So that's why my tip is to stand still until the camera starts moving. Although you will hear a shutter click, as I experienced, it doesn't really mean that the shot is taken. So I wait extra 5 or 4 seconds before moving to the next stage. Keeping this rule, I can walk around the camera as it turns, posing in each stage. And basically that's all. The clone effect will be created in camera without any need of further editing. If you are shooting with the app, you will immediately see the result with the clones on the image. Depending on your creativity or how quick you are, you can play around with different concepts in different locations. For example, I tried to do this indoors in my living room, running from the dining table to my armchair and my sofa. It was a little bit faster run than simply walking around the camera, but it was a big fun. And of course, there can be more people in the picture. Just make sure that everybody is on frame in each and every stage, and it will look awesome. Some of the ideas will be cool as 360 photos, which you can easily animate and save in a flat format, and some of them will be the most spectacular as little planets or inverted planets. It depends on. But I hope you like this trick and the idea of going creative with this special 360 camera. If you do, please thumbs up, and if you have any further ideas, please comment below and share your own trick. In the upcoming video, you will see an in-depth review of this Trisio Lite 2 camera, and I will show you how it takes its job when it comes to its original purpose, taking virtual tour photos. Until then, please hit the subscribe button if you haven't subscribed yet, and see you next time!